So now we will calculate the resistance from the graph. In Ohm's law, we get the voltage and current values. We join all the values, we get such a graph. From this graph, it is visible to all of you. If you calculate the slope of the graph, if you calculate the slope, that is tan theta. All of you know, you can write it I by V, delta I by V. And this is written as 1 by r, or you can say r is proportional, r equal to 1 by tan theta. Then inverse of the slope is giving resistance. Okay, and if the graph between V and I, suppose in some numerical the graph between V and I, then you will say if you get the slope tan theta, in this graph tan theta will be resistance. Now, if I increase the resistance, then what will happen to the slope here? Yes, in this situation, slope will decrease. If I say there are two resistances, R1 and R2, I will say R2 is more than R1. Similarly, I say this is for a conductor at temperature T1, this is for the same conductor at temperature T2. And if I ask you T1 is greater than T2 or T2 is greater than T1, all of you know for conductor, if we increase the temperature, for conductor, if temperature is increased, resistance also increases. It means I will say R2 is more than R1, T2 is more than T1. Now, what is the experimental setup? We have the resistor across the voltmeter, and there is a variable resistor. You can see it is a rheostat also. In some books, it is written as rheostat. Rheostat. Okay. So, we slowly move the variable resistance rheostat so that the voltage increases by 0.5 volt. We record the current for each setting. Now, we plot it. Graph between current and voltage. Suppose we take current on the y axis, voltage on the x axis. We plot all the values. Now we join it. This graph is straight line. So we see both voltage and current are proportional. This is the Ohm's law. The current flowing through a wire is directly proportional to the potential difference across it, provided the physical condition remain constant. Physical condition means everything, temperature, pressure, density, everything. Now you have to plot the current and voltage graph for nichrome and copper wire. Same experimental setup, we will put in the laboratory, we get the values. This is for nichrome. This is for copper. Now, we join. I hope you can recognize which material having more resistance. Here, graph current on y-axis, so you will say reciprocal of the slope. Steeper the gradient of current voltage graph, the lower the resistance of the wire. Now, we have to plot the current voltage graph for a bulb. You are observing such points. You join it. Graph produces not a straight line but a curved line. Increasing the voltage across the filament in the bulb causes this wire to get very hot and give out light. As the wire gets hotter, its resistance gets higher, which means current flow is less. So, as the temperature rises, the current is not proportional to voltage. Now, please tell me, Which of the component obey Ohm's law? Yes, right. A wire. Straight line graph. Here also third wire of different material is straight line graph. Now how can we model electric circuit? We can think the pizza shop in this way. In this model, the moped rider represents the flow of charge and the pizza represents the electrical energy carried around the circuit. All of you observe that is a battery. There is a pizza shop, driver take the pizza, then distribute the person, that is the resistance, they are taking the energy. Okay, now I am asking a question. You think and then reply. Okay, we can think the Ohm's law macroscopic form, that is E equal to rho j. And all of you know current density is given by current per unit area. In the question, it is given carry same current and same length and diameter area is same. So, this is same for both the material. It means you will say E totally depends on resistivity. And I think all of you know very well. Yes, resistivity of copper is greater than resistivity of silver. It means E for copper is greater than E for silver. Check the solution. Yes. Now resistance. What is resistance? So resistance, as we discussed in junior class also, opposition in the flow of current is known as resistance. Cause of resistance, it is a collision of the free electron with the ion or atom. That is the main cause of resistance. And resistance creates heat. You can see in this animation, small black color particles are electron, and big spheres are the copper atom. When electron are moving, they are colliding. So we say electricity in wire is a flow of electron along the wire. As the electrons move along the wire, they collide with the metal ions. These collision make the atom vibrate more, which makes the metal hotter, and this opposition is resistance. You can say resistance of a conductor is the opposition offered by the conductor to the flow of electric current. You can say ratio of voltage to current. This derivation I have done earlier. This you people know. And if I ask you SI unit of resistance, you will say ohm. And if I ask you define 1 ohm, you can define here 1 ohm is 1 volt upon 1 ampere. The factors on which resistance depend. We know this formula. I think all of you will say here mass of the electron is constant. So resistance depends on length. Resistance depends on n. N is the number of free electrons per unit volume. Different material have different number of free electrons. E is constant. Tau is the relaxation time. It depends on temperature. So you say resistance depends on temperature also, and R is proportional to 1 by A. There are four factors on which resistance depends. First is the material. Different material have different resistance, length, thickness, and temperature. You please pause the video and read all the points. Now I will explain you why does length affect resistance. Resistance is caused by electrons colliding with metal ions. When the length of the wire is increased, the electron have to travel further, so the chance of collision will increase. It causes the resistance to increase. Now I will explain why does cross section area affect resistance. Increasing the thickness of a wire increase the cross sectional area that the electron can flow through. This decrease the chance of collision with metal ion. Temperature dependence. I think we have discussed the temperature dependence in the class 11 thermodynamics, linear expansion, superficial expansion, volumetric expansion. At that time I told you temperature dependence, resistance also depend on temperature. And one formula I told at that time, RT equal to R naught 1 plus alpha T. For some material alpha is positive, it means if we increase the resistance, if we increase the temperature, resistance will increase. For some material alpha is negative, if we increase the temperature, resistance will decrease. Some material alpha is negligible, not affected by the temperature. I will discuss you this alpha. Now I will discuss variation of resistance of some electrical material with temperature. Metal, we know RT equal to R naught 1 plus alpha T. Okay, for metal we say alpha is greater than 0. It means resistance will increase with temperature. Can you explain it? Basically, in metal, collision frequency of free electron with the immobile positive ion also increases. Now you tell me solid non-metal. For solid non-metal, I will say alpha equal to 0. Non-metal, no free electron. You will say resistance is independent of temperature. How will you explain it? Complete absence of free electrons. The semiconductor. For semiconductor, we will say alpha is less than 0. I will discuss detail about semiconductor chapter. Here you will say resistance will decrease when temperature increases because alpha is negative. So if temperature increases, resistance will decrease of semiconductor. Physical explanation, you can say covalent bond breaks, liberating more free electron, that's why conduction increases. Again, I am telling you, in semiconductor we will see when we increase the temperature, covalent bond will break, then it will release more free electron. So conduction will increase, resistance will decrease. Electrolyte. For electrolyte also alpha is less than 0. Again, same condition, temperature increases, resistance decreases. Why? You will say when we increase the temperature, degree of ionization increases and solution become less viscous. What you say for ionized gas? Again, in gaseous situation you will read alpha is less than 0. So resistance decreases with temperature. Same reason, degree of ionization increased. Alloy. For alloy, generally we say alpha is the small positive value. Small positive value. You just learn it. Okay. So what will happen? With rise in temperature, resistance of alloy is almost constant. But one thing you are supposed to know, alloy resistance are slightly higher than pure metal resistance. Now I think if I ask you, why alloy are used to make standard resistance wire of resistance box, potentiometer, meter wise? All of you agree? Because their resistance is unaffected by the temperature. And simple example I can say for the alloy, you can learn it like constant N, like one I can say manganese. And I can say nichrome. No superconductor. There are some material at low temperature resistance becomes 0. These substances are called superconductor, and this phenomenon is known as superconductivity. So we will plot the graph for some material. If you decrease the temperature, resistance becomes, at particular temperature, resistance becomes zero. That material is known as superconductor. And the temperature at which resistance becomes zero, that is known as critical temperature. I say it is critical temperature at which resistance becomes zero. And it depends upon the nature of substance. So, all of you just pause the video and read all the slides. Conductance, it is the reciprocal of resistance, and its unit is reciprocal of the ohm. Now, I will discuss what is resistivity.